are live. We're live in the Vancouver rental.
With like shockingly attractive black cabinets. I never would have.
Never would have gone?
I would have gone all the way.
It's a sleek blackness.
Yeah, matte black, but deliciously beautiful. I said that.
You did. That's one of your words.
Did it delicious? Yeah.
Delicious.
Delicious.
It is. So guys, okay. I already chopped some stuff because I was like, you guys are, it literally took me like 40 minutes.
Like I showed up and she had like the bowls with the pre-measured ingredients.
It's like a real cooking show.
A satisfaction.
So this is the ginger. This is the onion. These are the shiitake.
We're making
up stupid jokes about it before I went on live, and I was like, "Oh, we gotta turn the live on." Missing all of the jokes.
Shiitake.
I don't even know. Okay. So if you're joining us, we are going to do a Jennifer Fisher recipe. Now, the one thing that I did say earlier, if you were paying attention, I don't have the specific kind of coconut curry that she talks about because the store I went to was a smaller store, and I think that's probably why we didn't stock it. But I do have this, which smells really good.
So we're just going to make our own. It smells nice. I definitely haven't used it before because I don't cook. This is really like a cooking lesson for me. But that smells great.
You know, you've seen this, Thai kitchen. You've seen this everywhere. I don't know if this is Jennifer Fisher approved because she's very specific about like ingredients and stuff. And so I don't know that like soybean oil might not be.
I wouldn't know.
In her list of clean things.
Okay. Okay, so it's a small cheat. You're just going to mix that with this?
Yeah.
We are?
Yeah. We're going to have to decide how much we should actually put in there.
Okay.
Which is going to be something that we...
Do you feel like people should see what you're chopping? Like,
sure. Do you guys want to see what I'm chopping? Is that more interesting?
The shiitakes. I will keep an eye on the comments. I feel like that's something I could do.
I have a hard time.
Someone says it does taste like curry
powder. Alex approved curry powder. That's right.
Okay. My husband just joined. Hi, Adam.
Hi, Adam.
That's cute. Guess you missed me.
He dropped you off like 5 minutes ago.
I know. He brought me over and he got right on. Are we codependent?
Maybe. Okay. Nice. So this is probably more than a cup. But
you don't care? This is what I admire about you. You don't sweat about the
portions.
Yeah.
Which I think sometimes is silly of me, right? I think that's silly. And it might get me into trouble occasionally.
It's just the confidence that I admire.
Thanks. I appreciate that.
Like Alex told me the other night, she made curry chicken
made curry chicken.
With no recipe.
No recipe.
Who are you?
I was scrolling through Instagram and I saw all these curry things being made and I was like, ooh, sounds like fun. Let's try that. And so...
But you just made it without anything.
Well...
You went rogue and it was good.
I had some chicken thighs in the fridge and so I rubbed some cumin and curry on it and salt, pepper, and then I just fried it up. Oh! So, there's a fun... I don't know. You... Probably a lot of you know how to do this already. I just was late to the party on how you use a stainless steel pan. Have you heard of this?
I asked you to teach me and I still don't know.
Okay. So, and this was a thing that I learned on Instagram.
Without burning it, you mean? Like using...
Yeah. So you put... Now, this is an induction stovetop, which...
Yeah, that's what we have.
I'm actually not mad at it. It heats up a lot faster than the old ones used to. So I have a gas top at home. So what you do is you heat it up. You have to get it really hot.
Do
you
have first?
To get the pan? Yes, so you get the pan really, really hot. And the way that you tell it it's hot is you sprinkle water on it. And if the water like fizzles and evaporates, it's not hot enough. But once it gets hot enough, the water will dance around in little bubbles on the surface.
Science!
It's amazing.
Is that true?
Yeah. And then I'm just gonna show you how it works.
Okay, great.
And then you can put your cooking oil and then like put a piece of chicken down and it's not gonna stick to the bottom of it.
That's how you make stainless steel nonstick. That's insane. Nobody taught me that.
Nobody knows this. My husband refuses to use any of our stainless steel pans in the kitchen because they always stick.
Yeah.
So it's like...
And cleaning it is a nightmare. And I feel like I'm always ruining my pots and pans.
Yeah.
I also learned and then completely forgot like a year later how to clean a cast iron.
Oh, pan. Yeah.
Because you don't use soap, right? Isn't it like with oil and salt or something?
You can use a little bit of soap, but you want to get the food off of it. I think a lot of people get confused and they leave like the food bits on there, and you're not supposed to leave the food bits.
But you're not supposed to like scrub it with hard soap.
You can scrub it with, like I use one of those handheld brushes and I just scrub it with warm water.
Yeah.
But then I coat it with oil when I'm done.
And you leave it oiled up in your pantry.
On the stove top or, yeah.
Guys, the education.
The education. Come to Georgia. Come to my kitchen. Come to my real kitchen.
That's a cooking show I would watch.
In my real kitchen?
Yeah, in your beautiful new kitchen.
I feel like I need somebody to edit it, like Jennifer Garner does, because she's pretty.
Yeah, she's got someone who like films you and edit. Well, that's what I'll do. I'll come and I'll edit. I'll film and edit you.
Wow, I threw away the stainless pot. See?
Oh, see, yeah, no.
Crazy.
Yeah. I've been doing that my whole life.
I feel like we've really missed something here.
So yeah, like it should come with
see how it's dancing?
Maybe they should see.
Okay.
Is it annoying to take this off?
No, just do it.
Okay, watch. Hold on. Hold on.
Ready?
I think it's filming because I can't. Look at the dancing.
See, it dances and then there are little beads of water on the...
I don't know if my camera work was right, but...
Did you guys see that, or was that incorrect? I hope not.
They'll edit it.
Okay.
Where is Martin?
All right, so...
Missing out is what he... Martin's missing out.
Martin's learning his lines, apparently.
He takes a couple days extra.
He takes a few days.
All right, what should I be doing?
All right, we're going to start making this. Are you guys ready to start making this, or are we just yammering on too much? So we start with the onions.
Put oil in there?
Okay, so I'm gonna turn this on, might be helpful.
See how helpless I am, guys?
you're doing great. So this is a stainless steel. I just, you know what, it's got a little bit of cooking oil from earlier because I just used it. So what I did with my leftover chicken curry last night was I heated it up and then I got one of those like tortillas that's not quite cooked, and I cooked a tortilla and I put the chicken in it and then I put some béarnaise on top of it with some cilantro. It was delicious. Delicious. Why? I don't know why.
Why?
I don't know why.
She was hungry. Y'all are not done filming. One thing I will be good at on this cooking show is fielding questions for you from what's on here, since you can't watch because you're doing the cooking.
Okay.
Please tell us the baby is Jax. I can't tell you that.
I can't tell you that, but if you tune in on Wednesday. If you watch the show on Wednesday.
It's happening Wednesday.
You'll find out. We're gonna answer that question for you this season.
So many questions are gonna be resolved.
Whose do you think it is?
Yeah.
Jax. Or Mark's baby.
Brittany Murphy's twin? When did Alex get interested in cooking? Yeah, great question.
Oh, I actually just talked about that on an interview for Connecticut Magazine. I was interested in cooking when I was a kid. I used to pretend to be Julia Child in the kitchen for my mother, who thought it was really funny. Yeah. I didn't know what I was doing, but, all right, I'm going to turn that down because I feel like that's too. Okay. I'm going to put in the onion.
This is my favorite smell in a kitchen.
Might be a lot of onion.
I first got interested in cooking, I'd say like a couple hours ago. I'm great at peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. Macaroni and cheese in a box. You know, like, it's a hard ratio for that powdered cheese to get, like, the butter and milk right without it being too soggy. I have that down pat.
Do you whisk the creme? You make it the cream?
I'm sorry, what? You put creme in your...
No, like, to make it creamy, do you, like, whisk it with the milk and the butter and the powdered cheese?
No.
Oh, yeah.
I have
That's
so
something
much
you should
to
do.
Learn this season. Whisking it.
Yeah. So when you take the pasta out and you, I always use the same pan. So I put it in the sink. I guess you could probably pre-whisk it. You could make the sauce before, while you're making the pasta.
Yeah.
That's a good tip I gave myself. But so you put the milk and the butter in the pan by itself and then whisk in the powdered cheese because then it you can get all the lumps out. If you just put it in the pasta, you're gonna end up with lumpiness.
I'm not gonna lie, I don't mind a lump or two, do you know what I mean?
It's you like it?
Cheesy hit, but yes, it shouldn't, here. I just felt like I did great stirring there. I prevented things from burning.
Did.
Okay, that was the garlic.
So I put the onion in and the garlic in, and then I just added the ginger.
Oh, that's ginger.
That's ginger. Okay. It looks really similar to garlic, though.
Guys.
What time is it in Brazil, guys? The easiest homemade mac and cheese.
It's called Kraft macaroni in a box.
I use Annie's, and I actually like it
Annie's
much better now.
Annie's is good. It's healthier as well, isn't it?
Well, I'm supposed to be, but I don't. Who knows?
Best fave. These questions come so fast.
They do. I know. I can't keep up with.
Watch your pan. Okay, right. Thank you. No, good, because it's a little bit burning. Do you want it to be browning? Not burning, but browning.
I'll turn it down a little bit. Okay, I'm going to put the mushrooms in.
I washed the fish earlier, so. You know, I don't want to boast.
Good. Just stick it all on there.
I feel like you can never have too many mushrooms, but I love mushrooms.
Yeah.
I'm an aspiring vegetarian, so mushrooms are like my meat.
Team Sophie, thanks, guys. Have you,
yes.
So Jennifer Fisher, who this recipe is from her website, she makes this. I think they're portobellos, and she makes them into like a portobello bacon. So she uses smoke, like liquid smoke and stuff.
Yeah.
And they're pretty good. I made them one night.
Yeah.
These are shiitake mushrooms.
Her website looks amazing. All of her recipes.
Just so you know, somebody commented on my Republican state, and I'd like you to know that our state went blue this last election.
Yes.
So I'm just saying.
Represent. What was their comment? Was it nice?
How can you stand to live in such a Republican state?
Guess it's not anymore. Tokyo? This is pretty amazing. Winnipeg? Close by-ish? Canadian. When's Martin going to do the cooking show with you guys? When Martin learns his lines.
Yeah.
Bree and Brady. Okay. Shiitake is Japanese. Yes. Brazil.
All right, I'm gonna consult with the recipe, guys. You made 48 cupcakes and a sheet cake. That's a lot of baking for
I've
one day.
I've never had a sheet cake, and I would like one. Team Mike. You know what, Gracie, I think it's Gracie, or Grace Eat. Anyway, I see you come up a lot on Instagram. I know you're Team Mike. I love that. Cooking mushrooms as well. Washington State.
Probably should have opened this can.
Oh, wait,
before.
Martin.
Is it? Did you come on?
Is that it?
Oh, gosh.
I'm getting a
Hold on, guys.
Oh.
I don't know why that's working. I mean,
what's up, girls?
We miss you.
Oh, I'm sure you don't, but
we do, though.
I'm sure you guys have got it handled.
You're missing out on a sick-ass meal. Did you see what we're making?
Alex sent me the recipe or something. It sounded very sophisticated.
I think it's
it?
I don't know. It feels kind of like, well, I'm no cook, but it feels kind of easy. Alex is doing a bam job.
Seems easy.
She's very good, though. Do you want to know why I can't join you? Do you want to see why I can't?
Yeah.
You're making stuffed squash flower blossoms.
Zucchini? Yeah, I just made stuffed, zucchini flowers.
Now that's sophisticated. Who are you?
Why didn't you bring that over here and make it with us? What's wrong with you? Yeah. I don't understand.
I told you, I was learning my lines. I'm like so behind the eight ball right now, but that's all right.
Martin, how far in advance do you learn your lines, though, exactly?
I like to be a week ahead.
A week ahead?
Yeah.
I didn't know that about you.
Oh, for sure, because then I can enjoy the whole week.
The day of.
You're a week
Alex ahead. Is like during the rehearsal, like literally during the rehearsal.
Yeah, I do that.
Respect.
It's true.
Respect. How do you even hang on to those lines for an entire week? That is so much in advance.
Well, then I can just forget about it and do other fun things like make zucchini flowers. Yeah.
Why are you making this? Have you ever made this before? And why?
No, because I was at the farmer's market this morning with Jen and my buddy Dave. And they had these fresh flowers. So we're like, oh, let's do stuffed zucchini flowers. And so I did it. And they look a little sad. I got to say, they're a little flat.
They look a little, a little flaccid. But that's all right.
The egg and the bread comes next.
No, but it's all right. I did goat's cheese with rosemary, fennel. What else did I put in there? Oh, green onion and lemon zest. They're going to taste good.
They sound really tasty. Look what Alex is doing.
I feel like this just got really soupy, and I didn't even put the whole can in.
Are you supposed to reduce it?
Yeah. Uh-oh. We're going to be here a while, everybody.
Uh-oh. The internet's going to break. You guys are going to be chatting away.
No, I'm everybody's going to leave the live. Nobody's going to watch anymore. Like, I'm gonna
just leave it on your soup. Just like people can watch it.
Nothing more entertaining than watching just soup cook down. it's about as fun as watching paint dry.
Yeah, but at least it's better to eat than paint. So
are you only having squash blossoms, or are you doing something else?
No, that's the appetizer.
Excuse-le-me.
Excuse-moi. Now, Dave's getting burgers. Look, Dave's got burgers. We got a manly meal coming up.
Oh.
Broccolini on the grill.
Say hi to everybody, Dave.
Hi, everybody. Dave. How are you?
Good. Hi, Dave.
Oh, I missed him there.
This is my finger cheese slicer. I'm going to try to figure this out. I don't think it's going to work.
That is not a finger cheese slicer, seriously.
Well, I just found it in the drawer, and I'm making it that, but we'll see what happens.
Please
I
think do that a might demonstration for us.
Show people how to use the finger slicer.
No, this is experimental. I don't suggest this.
He doesn't want his debut to be.
I've never seen it or done it before. No.
I'll turn the camera around. I'm turning it around. Go, Dave.
No.
Go, Dave. Do it.
It's slicing, but it's not slicing like.
That's really slice. Funny.
Oh my god. Fingers
what's your thumb there, buddy?
I'm not going for that.
What is that
work.
For exactly, though?
We can't find the proper cheese slicer in this house.
Oh, there's got to be.
This, this
is the best stacked kitchen I've ever been in.
Just use a knife. Silly goose.
Oh, actually, pushing it this way. Pushing it this way.
Oh, pushing! Dave's.
Yeah, pushing. Yeah, it's going to work.
Push it like you mean it. Look at that.
Push it.
When dudes get together to make a meal.
Yeah, we push our cheese around the plate.
Yeah.
Yeah, push it, Dave.
That's how it goes.
Yeah.
Floss, floss, and burgers.
Oh, yeah, geez, Dave.
There's some broccoli here and some
blossoms and burgers.
Yeah, no, there's nothing more manly than a squash blossom appetite.
Well, I had, yeah, we had to balance out the squash flower debacle.
Alex, what are you doing now? Are you even interested? I feel like you need to be a little more envious of our meal.
Yeah. I should let you guys go. I'm going to go and eat my my stuffed squash blossoms before they get tepid.
Okay. Before they get tepid?
Yeah, before they get, like, you know, lukewarm.
Bless.
Nobody wants a lukewarm blossom.
Blossom? No.
You need that blossom hot.
That's right. We were going to make fish tacos today, and I said, no, we need to wait for Martin to do that.
Oh. Too many innuendos, yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
I was like, we'll make this cod thing instead.
Oh, some low-hanging fruit there. Okay.
It is. I know, that's why. I was like, yeah. Oh, no.
Okay, stuffed tacos. Well, listen.
Fish tacos, honey.
Fish tacos.
You said stuffed tacos. It's fish
tacos. You bring the fish, I'll bring the tacos.
Gross.
All right. I love you guys. I'll see
Bye,
you.
I love you. Enjoy your meal.
Yeah. Good luck with your soup.
It's going to be great.
It's not going to be soup. It's already reducing.
Yeah. It's not soup.
It's going to be amazing. You're a very good cook.
I know. She's so good. I'm just standing here.
Yeah. You're like, what's that?
I'm like,
Muppets. Yeah. There was like the chef, right? But wasn't there like, you're like Beaker.
Oh, is that what I'm like?
I don't know. No, I love you.
I'm just like an ineffective sous chef.
No, but it's like part of the show. It's like you're like the attractive, you know, like the lady that turns the letters on what is that, Wheel of Fortune. You're like, you know.
Savannah White?
Yeah, yeah, you're like the Savannah White.
You want
White
me back,
of,
you want me back.
Inappropriate cool. Cooking show.
Yeah, love it.
All right, we'll do the next one.
Been attractive.
Huh? No, I was going to say something inappropriate. I'll see you guys at work.
Okay, enjoy your meal.
Thanks.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. How do I end this thing?
You're stuck here.
I know, I'm going to say something really inappropriate, thinking it's off. Oh, are you guys screwing with me? Do you need to turn it off? Oh, no, here I
don't think.
Oh, there he goes. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
A little bit being like an old man with technology, huh?
Yeah, Martin doesn't totally know what he's doing with technology. Wait, okay.
This
so
looks
now.
So nice, actually. Okay, so now fish, right?
Now fish.
I feel like, let me just show people the progression. So the kale's in there, the shiitake mushrooms. You added that curry paste to the coconut, right?
I did, because we didn't get the coconut curry that was on the website. Sorry.
How much did you do though? Just like a tiny little. Tiny spoon. Look at this cute little tiny spoon.
Tiny spoon.
I love tiny stuff.
Okay, I'm gonna make. So I'm just gonna cut some of this fish, and I'm actually just gonna do three fillets of fish.
One for you, one for me, and one for Martin.
Who's not coming. I almost got him here today, guys. Almost. It was close. It was a close one.
I love that you like found squash blossoms in the farmer's market when you come to stuff them.
Well, you know, something about Martin, everybody. Martin was, he was a vegetarian for about a year. I met him, he drank boatloads of coffee, ate tons and tons of meat, and then decided suddenly to become a vegetarian. And now he's eating meat and drinking coffee again.
What?
So, yeah.
Martin, you're drinking coffee again?
Yes. He's doing all the things that he said he wouldn't do.
Listen, we all change our minds, man.
All right, I'm gonna get, so on her cooking show, because you know, Jennifer Fisher, I don't know if any of you guys follow Jennifer Fisher. but she, on her website, so she's a jewelry designer, but she started, I know it's weird, because you're like, I'm going here for cooking, but why is this person? I think she's,
She's an overachiever. She does a lot of things. Yes. She's very creative and she's kind of like a nonstop human. And on her website, she's got, I mean, she sells all these salts, Jennifer Fisher salts, which are delicious. Yeah. So she's got universal salt, spicy salt, and curry salt. She actually doesn't use the curry salt in this curry for whatever reason. I don't know. But anyways, so on her Instagram, she does cooking constantly, and all of her food is dairy-free and grain-free. And the stuff that she uses, I don't have a big enough. There is not a bigger one.
What about a cookie sheet? That's what I do. Because you want to cover it, right?
I don't have a big enough lid because I'm in a rental. No. Let's see. I have. What's this?
Oh, careful.
No, I'll hold that's something that. Weird. What is that?
Oh, that's for washing dishes. That's usually my job. That's why I recognize it.
Why is the drying rack up at the very tippity top of the sink? I'm gonna put it down here so we can find it.
This feels really like important content. Really important content. What about in here? There's. How do you open it? This is a very modern, like, could you pull one of those pans out? See that?
Oh, and yeah.
Stick it upside
down?
Smart. Thanks for saying so.
Thanks for coming over and being so smart with me.
Just call me the MacGyver of kitchen tools.
So there's that, guys. We figured that out.
Hey. Cool. That works. So how long do we cover it for?
Well, I don't know because it doesn't actually say on her website, but if you watch her video, she talks about it. I don't want to watch the video of somebody making food on Instagram. It really sounds weird.
Yeah, it's a little too meta. So are we just supposed to like wing it?
Yeah, that's what I'm doing. So, well, I watched it a few times, so I do know that you should use the fish thing.
What if you don't have that?
Use a regular spatula. I just bought one of these. Because I was like, I'm going to use it someday. I still haven't used it at home, but I'm going to use this one in the rental.
Oh, so the rental came with a fish spatula?
It did.
They thought of everything.
They really did. About 8 minutes. What's 8 minutes?
Oh, wait for 8 minutes? Oh, my gosh.
It said 1 to 2 on the thing.
Oh, someone asked, who is this food blogger?
Jennifer Fisher.
And we're making fish, but it doesn't only make fish. The name has nothing to do with it.
Yeah. So if you go into my stories, I link her website and her Instagram account.
Yeah, and I was confused for a second. I thought you were tagging your jewelry, which I was actually excited about because your jewelry is so pretty. And I was like, yes, tag the jewelry too, because I bet people want to know what it is. But you weren't doing that. Team Mike. Okay. Hi from Santa Claus, Indiana. You live in a place called Santa Claus?
Santa Claus, Indiana.
That's so cool. As you can. Martin left to eat his squash blossoms.
They're like, where did Martin go? Things were so much more fun.
This looks so pretty.
It's been 1 to 2 minutes since I put them on.
I think so. Do you guys think it's been 1 to 2 minutes?
This is how I cook, guys. This is why. These normal people who cook put timers on things.
This is why I'm just like, teach me your ways, because I am the least confident person in the kitchen. I have to be so by the book.
But that's okay.
I don't know. Just like, it takes the joy out of it, whereas you're just like... Oh, I like this taste. I'll put that in. Oh, this feels right. Oh, I'm just going to wing it, talk to some people, and do this, and then it's delicious. You're like...
Sometimes it's not, though. Sometimes I don't get it right, and it's bad.
I have yet to experience that. You've always made really tasty stuff.
So, this is what it's looking like, everybody.
She just flipped them. So now we're inside.
It smells...
So good.
Delicious.
What about noodles?
Noodles! So, here's the deal. And it's turned around, which is the most obnoxious thing to me about Instagram. Can you just mirror image me?
Yeah, can't you flip it? No.
Miracle Noodle is a plant-based noodle. It's made out of this stuff called konjac. Am I pronouncing that correctly?
Konjac? No idea.
So it's like, this whole package is 10 calories. Hence, made out of plant.
Miracle noodle.
Miracle noodle. And it's quite good. And so this is what Jennifer Fisher uses. I had some already. This is what the store had today.
They're squishy. So. They're not dry. Like, I thought they were going to be dry in the packet. They're, like, squishy noodles.
So last night what I did, do you want to cut? You can have it into this.
This is a good job for me. Here you go. I haven't done a single thing yet.
Okay, you do that. You cut them open and put them into the strainer.
The strainer?
Yeah, you can use the salad strainer.
Do you guys want to cut expertly?
Is anybody else cooking on a Sunday?
Someone made cupcakes. Do they smell the noodles? Let's see.
No.
They don't. Nothing.
Nothing.
Absolutely nothing. Nothing. No information is given through the olfactory experience. Okay. Do we rinse them?
I know that we eat them.
Okay.
So we just, I want to, oh, where's the other package? Here.
Two of them?
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, this is more food than you and I can eat. Martin really blew it. Adam, you want to come back? It's double packaged, guys. You know. Just so you know.
Double packaged.
Yeah.
Well, the other one's not double packaged.
Wow, they're really slimy and, like, they're not.
You could rinse. You want to rinse them?
I think.
Give them a rinse.
Maybe just a little rinse. There's, the slime factor might.
It's getting gross, yeah.
Put you off a little bit.
Somebody just said, Alex, great job. You lost weight. Actually, guys, I don't think I did. I think I gained some.
Also, like,
we can talk about that.
Gain it, lose it, great job both ways. Who cares?
Well,
we love our bodies.
I don't know why that's even a comment.
Hello. Yeah. Rude. It's weird. It's funny. Don't like having some a habit I'm trying to break because I think I just learned it in our generation. Is that, like, especially when women they grade each other, the instinct is to.
Oh,
my dad's calling me. Sorry, Dad. The instinct is to, like, compliment somebody's looks, mm-hmm. and I'm trying not to do that mm-hmm. because I think there are other ways we can compliment each other without, like, singling out their looks. Like, even if someone, I do it sometimes. I compliment you all the time.
We compliment each other.
Yeah.
I compliment
but
you.
But, you know, I haven't even seen someone in a long time, and you comment on their body, their looks. Like,
yeah. Well, that's the natural, that's what people do. Like,
yeah,
people are always like, you look great. And
yeah.
you're like, but I think it's not just, like, how you look. I think how you look is supposed to also encapsulate, like, how you must be feeling or how you must be doing in life.
Yeah.
Like, if you look like a total emotional mess.
Yeah. You look rough, man.
That's so good.
Yeah, like, I said the other day to a girlfriend, I was like, you look so radiant. And then I was like, it just feels like you look so happy. Because that's because it sometimes translates. But anyway, it's an interesting mm-hmm. thing.
Yeah.
We're
no,
not
that's the
thing.
That's what right. it is. That's what I...
Yeah.
You
sense.
Look good. You look good.
You look happy. For the most part.
You don't have control over your lips.
No, not really. Yeah, no.
Unless you get a bunch of plastic surgery, I suppose.
And even then. You know what I mean? The outcome is in the surgeon's hands. Wow, this looks tasty, and it really did reduce down. It's not soup at all, Martin. He's not watching. So what are you doing with this? Are you putting it in water or just warming the slimy noodles up because they're already pretty moist?
Well, Jennifer Fisher says to warm them up and, like, to help sort of dry them out.
Okay.
You don't have
with
to
no
put them with no water. Well, because you don't want to, if you're trying to dry them out, you don't want to put water. Right.
My two daughters watch it. They love it too. Oh, I missed it. Curry time. He is watching. Like New Zealand.
Moist. Yeah, that's right. Moist.
I knew someone was going to comment on that word. It's all wrong saying it.
Moist.
I mean, we're practically there already.
Yeah.
You made us in a minute.
Meal. Well, you helped make us an amazing meal.
You know, I washed the fish, I opened the noodle package.
You drained the noodles.
I drained them. Yep.
You rinsed the noodles.
What about these guys?
Those are jalapenos.
and onions, and I've got...
How cute is it that she measured these out ahead of time?
You do this at home? Like, when you're cooking, do you prep like that?
It depends on the day.
And then, always put your fresh herbs in a cup of water in the fridge.
I
started doing that, I think I was working on season two. I was out here working on season two, and I can't remember if I saw it somewhere or if I was just like, if it seems to me like they would do better if you put them in water because they're a plant.
I mean, it makes perfect
sense.
Like,
in my mind, I was like, I think that's what happened.
It makes perfect sense, and it's adorable. So yours is in a little mug.
It's in a little mug, yeah. Usually I put them in, a mason jar,
which is also cute. It's very Pinterest-worthy.
Yes. Right. I feel like it's appropriate in Georgia, a mason jar. Right. So, I mean, really the only place that we're getting calories in this meal is from the coconut.
That's great,
right?
Yeah, I love that.
It's pretty good.
So a lot of her whole thing is healthy, clean eating, right?
Yes, yeah.
And I mean, hopefully you guys will go to her website, because I feel like I just have a gold mine for recipe inspiration.
Yeah, it's great. My friends in Georgia turned me on to her stuff, and can you show the mason jar? I don't have one.
It's at home.
It's at home.
Somebody's watching Virgin River 3 right now. They're watching from the beginning. You can sing it, girls. Someone said my onions are moldy. That sounds wrong. That sounds like a really funny caption.
I hate it when your onions get moldy.
Yeah, I hate moldy onions. Gosh, there's so many people from all over the world. It's pretty amazing, you guys. How many episodes in season 5? Are we allowed to say?
Yeah, there's 12.
Yeah.
Oh, there's 12. I don't know. I mean, they already announced that. Yeah, that's fine.
Or you heard it here first, folks.
Hey.
Someone just shouted, I'm in Hawaii and my onions are moldy. Why does that make
that
me laugh?
That is unfortunate.
Why does it make me laugh so hard?
You're trying to make chicken noodle soup. Oh, and you need those onions. Can you cut the moldy part around the onion? Because maybe the inside is okay?
I would not trust.
I don't know. Sometimes.
Even a partially moldy.
You're going to cook it. It's soup.
Well, what
do you have onion powder?
Because you got instead of an onion?
Well, if you're in a pinch.
Is that a pun? She did it.
It was
like a powder and just a pinch.
Okay, you didn't mean to, but it was good. I'm not that fast. No. I'm 100% not quick enough. No. Oh. All right. These noodles seem ready.
They look like glass noodles. You know, glass, you know?
Yeah.
They're really translucent. That one pack said it was 5 calories per. Okay, wait. Can I see this?
We're gonna put our noodles in a bowl. I know. I don't know if we can eat all those noodles.
It's a lot of food. I mean, I'll probably eat it. I'm an eater.
Alright. Now we've got our fish.
It's official. We cooked.
So bad
I had to get one in.
That was good.
This genuinely looks delicious.
Now the trick comes where you're trying to get the sauce around the fish so that you can get it in your noodles, but then put the fish on top without trying to break the fish.
What are you talking about? So you're layering in the sauce first.
I'm trying to get it to look pretty.
Yeah.
I'm trying to make it look.
Yeah. This is practical.
Instagram worthy. Mm-hmm. Fish.
Yes, I'm going to take an Instagram photo.
Well, we're not done yet.
Okay. I'm going to set. This is where my skills start to Good one, Zibby. About my fish pun, thank you. One person liked it. It's all I need. I love like dad jokes. It's my favorite thing. It's my passion.
Casey does a lot of dad jokes.
Does he?
Yeah.
Right. We'll have a dad joke.
I feel like Martin does a lot of dad jokes.
Yeah, I feel like he does. Nice.
We gotta put the stuff on top though.
Oh yeah. Okay,
so how much of this do you want on there?
Little, so you're just meant to sprinkle a little bit of red onion.
Mm-hmm.
Just cute little measuring, a little tiny bowl. Should I do it?
Yeah.
I'm so scared.
No, put however much you want. Like,
how much do you want? I did just wash my hands. I'll let you do it. You garnish. I don't like spice, but I'm going to do just like a touch
of
mayo because it's part of the recipe. Cilantro?
Cilantro, for those of you that are not allergic to cilantro.
Or, you know, there's like a group of people that cilantro tastes like soap to them.
But that's the people that they're allergic to.
Oh, I didn't realize that. That means you're allergic?
Mm-hmm.
I love right. cilantro. Is anyone here allergic to cilantro? The official dad joke teller. Thank you.
Yeah, all those jokes that you did on, what was it, Halloween?
Oh, yeah.
Was hysterical.
Yeah. Oh, thank you so much. I'm going to do it again. I'm going to find the themes over the season to, like, really pester people with.
Some limes.
Wow, guys, it smells so good. Alex.
Beautiful.
You're amazing.
Look at.
Look at this gorgeous.
Gorgeous dinner.
Let me photograph.
It's got kale in it as well. So you're getting your greens in there.
You're getting your roughage.
Your roughage.
No.
I love some roughage. I think we should put it somewhere and like make a thing when we're done with the gram.
Yeah, this photo?
Yeah. Oh gosh, you should go study for that.
I'm gonna go study.
Good luck with that.
It tastes like soap to me. Is that really an allergy?
I mean, that's.
It's a real thing. So.
I mean, I'm not a doctor, okay? I don't know.
She just plays one fish.
I just play a nurse. I keep playing nurses. I don't know what that's about.
Okay.
Hi!
First of all, congratulations on making us an amazing meal.
We're drinking tequila, everybody, just so you know. Yeah.
Just a little tequila.
Just a little tequila on a Sunday. Yeah.
I feel like I learned a couple of things.
Mm.
One, just to review, stainless steel pan. The way you use it is you heat it up first. And the way you know it's hot enough is when it's been on the stove, you just a little bit of water on there, and if the water evaporates, it's not hot enough. If the little water bubbles dance, you're in the sweet spot.
Yeah. Water beads, like they're beads. Water beads, yeah.
Okay. Huge. That's huge.
Mm-hmm.
What else did I learn?
That's what we're drinking.
Yeah. But this is not impairing. This is actually helping my education. What else did I learn? You can, when you rinse a fish, this is how rudimentary, you rinse it and then you suck it on paper towel just to absorb.
We usually I don't rinse fish, but we did today because it was kind of fishy.
Why don't you normally just like keep the oils on it?
I don't know. I've just never been taught to rinse fish. Do you guys rinse fish? Do you rinse your fish?
Guys, this is
Is anybody funny. Out there rinsing their
Martin
fish?
Martin wants to know, actually. Does anybody rinse their fish? Well, you know what? Honestly speaking, you're not supposed to. Like, you're not supposed to use. It's a self-cleaning. Anyway. It's a self-cleaning mechanism. Anyway. Okay. So, fish, you can do it or not. You could rinse. I also learned about these noodles, which I'm really excited about because they're low calorie.
So I think people are saying yes to rinsing the fish.
I guess everybody rinses their fish. Great.
I'm just saying.
Cheers to all
Cheers
the
to rinsing your fish.
Rinsed fishes.
Okay. Cheers. Somebody said no. I don't know. Maybe.
Sherry does not. Yes. Sherry does not.
Some people just think it's so funny. I mean, it is.
I mean, it's all my meat. You should. If I'm mad at the meat, it should all be rinsed.
Okay, good. Well, at least some people are laughing. We haven't offended. Don't like fish. You might like this.
What's your last name? You can do this. What? Who? Me?
Yes,
Breckenridge. It's easy. Breckenridge. Like, it's phonetic.
Absolutely. Rinsing and cleaning is a must, ladies. Can't wait for it to
remember. Oh my gosh. You know, I'm trying to teach my daughter that is, like, really an uphill battle. But she's not into it.
Vegan, don't rinse.
I'm confused. Vegan. Vegans don't eat fish.
Yeah. What's your favorite thing to cook? I mean, I think I said my mac and cheese. Yeah, out of the box.
Mac and cheese from a box.
Yeah, I'm the one that does the dishes in every house I go to because they cook and I clean. But I'm learning. Like, maybe this season I'll become, the tables will turn and I'll be, because of you and your influence. She's very influential on me.
Influencer.
Yeah. She's like my number one influencer. So maybe after this season, I'll be like,
cooking all the time.
What do you want me to whip up for you in the kitchen?
I think once you know the flavors that you enjoy and you understand kind of like cooking basics, it's pretty easy to cook. I've been really interested in flavors that aren't, you know, necessarily like American, you know, like more, I've been wanting to branch out, you know, to different cultures and different kinds of, just different flavors, different, you know, palates, whatever. So I took a cooking class with this lovely, lovely woman named Asha Gomez in Georgia. And I learned how to make, oh my gosh, what did I learn how to make? She made this rice. It was bananas. I'm terrible at making rice. I always burn it.
That's the one thing I can do. I'm here for you. I can do rice. I'm really good at rice. It's like, I'm so good at rice. Anyway, we digress.
So you just like leave the cover on. Is that how you do it?
Yeah, but like I can actually do rice. Like I can eyeball the amount and then like feel when it's ready. I don't have to do anything. Mm. Okay, but what's this rice though? It sounds like fancier than just leave the cover on and walk away.
I'm racking my brain to try to remember what's in it, but I'm pretty sure there were mustard seeds and I know that there was tons of cilantro on it, onion. Oh, and she put cranberries in it.
Yeah.
It was delicious.
I love a sweet and savory mix.
Somebody said you should eat, it's getting cold. You're right.
Okay, you're right. Yeah, we're sitting here just like chatting. Yeah.
You're right.
Okay.
Should we taste it?
Let's taste it. My husband hates it when people eat on camera and in cooking shows, and I'm about to do it.
But you need to taste
it, yeah.
To be like, oh, this is awful, or oh, this is delicious, right?
Only honest answers. I actually need a spoon to collect the noodle. Do you want one?
No, that's good. I'm okay. I'll get into a spoon when we're...
Don't you guys do that? Like, where you do the thing and you do the...
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Smells nice.
I could have extra salt on this.
Oh, I love it. I don't even need salt. That is so nice. It's got a tiny kick, but I'm not a spice girl. I'm actually not a spice girl.
She's never a spice girl.
In case there was any confusion.
She was never part of the Spice Girls.
But you're going to add jalapeno to yours.
I'm going to put some more, yeah. Because I could have more heat. I'm so Irish. So Irish. And just like British. That I can't handle a lot of spice. But something happened in the last couple of years, and it wasn't COVID, and now I can eat a lot of spicy food.
You had an internal shift.
I did. Do you know that your body changes every 7 years?
I heard this, yes. I read this. My very Irish husband loves spice. Like, he
he gets that stuff that just like burns through your system.
Really?
Yeah.
Like a Thai chili or
something?
Yeah,
like we have to like stay out of the room for a long time afterward.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, but that's
stay out of the room for a long time. So sadly, I left my Jennifer Fisher salts in.
Oh, so you have a bunch.
In Georgia. I have a whole bunch of Jennifer Fisher spicy salt, which is what she recommends on this. But so I bought that, which is a.
You gotta show them.
A spice. This is Italian. It's just not something that you're gonna be mixing with your Thai spice.
Here's what I'll say. This feels really healthy, and it feels like it's gonna be filling.
Mm-hmm.
Like a full dinner.
Yes.
That I won't have any regrets about.
No. Yeah, the pasta is good. I've been eating kelp pasta for a while.
Kelp pasta?
Yeah. Kelp noodles. I put them in like chicken broth. They're delicious.
So that's a real thing.
Mm-hmm.
And you endorse it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Thanks for watching, everybody. We should probably let you go so we can stuff our faces
Thanks
now.
Thanks for my dinner.
Thank you for washing my noodles.
Anytime.
Bye. I'm going to figure out how to stop this and
the eggs, maybe?